Okay, here's the newest AT Pro. I just got it yesterday. It's supposed to be straight from the distributor, straight from Garrett. So it should be the newest one out. And I'm just gonna show you that it does not have the coil faulting problem like the first one did. Turn it on. You can see the sensitivity is wide open. I'm in pro mode. 40 on the iron disc. Everything's accepted. Sorry about that. I'm just going to shake it for you and show you that it does not fault. I'm shaking it pretty dang hard there, as you can see. And it does not fault one bit. And let's see, here's some twigs. Does not fault on those. You see it is on. It does work. Let me get it across the targets. So it is working. You can see it does not fault one bit. So whatever they came up with, or I had a bad one to start with, there was a batch of bad ones, it does not fault. And it's an extremely, extremely deep machine. I was going to show you some of the air test depths. Let me lay my ruler out here. Piece of tape on to hold it. Let me set this camera down just for a second. Got the machine set up here with a ruler. I've got a few targets laying back here. There you are. Just a few things. Okay, here it is set up. I got it leaning against a tree, and here's the ruler. You can get the camera away from it. There's 17, 18, 19. Looks like the tape is right around 21 inches there. I was just going to try to show you, like, here's a nickel. As you can see it. Does about 16 on a nickel. Here's an old spoon handle. It's about 18 inches. Here's a toe tap. About 16 and a half. Here's a horseshoe, just a busted up horseshoe. You'll hear it breaking up on it. Let me turn the iron audio on this thing. And you can hear the horseshoe with the iron audio. And that's just some beautiful audio. I just love the way that thing sounds on iron. You can hear it trying the high tone in there. Let's see if you turn the iron audio off. You just hear little spits and sputters, and that's using the 40 disc. I can run the iron disc down to about 33, I believe, on that. And go a little lower. You can hear it trying to come in there. You turn the iron audio back on. You can hear it bleeding in. I've been running mine in the upper 30. You can really tell the iron by, you hear it. Hear the iron coming. You can hear it coming with the iron, with it off. You might get fooled sometimes on that big iron, but with it on, hear it coming. There's no way to miss it. And see, like, here's on them good targets. This was with the iron audio on now. You don't hear it coming. Iron, you hear it coming. Hear that iron coming? Good target does not come. Good target sounds just like it does with the iron audio off. And that's a pretty good piece of iron right there. Let's see what, if we mix something in there with it. That's like a spoon hammer. Hear that spoon handle coming in there? It's laying right next to that horseshoe right there. Listen to it coming in there. That's what it does with the iron audio off. Sounds good either way. That's a very hard target right there too, because that horseshoe is a solid iron and it's got a heck of a halo. And that, I know that spoon handle's pretty good size, but still, anybody that's experienced hunting an iron would know that that's a pretty amazing feat right there. Okay, well, basically what I wanted to do was show you that the depth was still there. It still performed like it the first one. But they've taken care of the faulting. It's just no faulting whatsoever. I'm extremely pleased with the machine. Okay.